Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the finest Dawn of War themed games cast this side of East Yorkshire. And today we've got a 2 versus 3 on the map of Gorgon in Ultimate Apocalypse. Playing on the side of the Lamenters, we have got the Good King and we have got Tiger Shark. And playing as the Foul Xenos, we have got a Flipping Gnome cosplaying as the Gene Steel Cultists. And we've also got me and we've got Lord Inquisitor playing as the Tyranids. It's quite exciting. Themed game going on for today. It's not really specifically referencing any kind of specific match or themed battle that happened in the Warhammer lore, although I do believe there is something very similar to this where the Lamenters protected a hive city or hive world from some incoming Tyranids, but like we didn't have a decent five-player city map to do on, so what, we're in the frozen waste, baby. That's where we're going to be defending the citizens of the Imperium today. So it's 2 versus 3. These guys are quite experienced and seasoned playing as Space Marines in Ultimate Apocalypse, whereas, I mean, me specifically, never played Tyranids in Ultimate Apocalypse before. Not sure how Lord Inquisitor is, I'm not sure how Flipping Gnome is on Imperial Guard, but, I mean, these guys, they're good, so realistically, it balances itself out in the grand scheme of things. We also have lots of narrow choke points for them that they can use for defensive purposes. The only thing that they really struggle with is maybe defending this central point here, where maybe, potentially, there's lots of flanking opportunities there for them. So have to wait and see how things go about. They've got Space Marines, which are very tanky, very chunky, quite hard for a single Tyranid model to kill, unless of course they go for like the bigger Tyranid warriors. We do have Spine Gots coming over onto this side. Tiger Shark doing some fantastic roleplay all the way through. Our lives matter no longer. What's the phrase that the Lamenters use? For those we cherish, we die in glory. Which, I mean, I'll be honest, I'm sure that I'm... There we go. I'm saying that the only thing that a Tyranid can say back is rah. But, like, you know, you must know, back in the Mad Chemical Romance emo days, when, you know, rah is I love you in dinosaur, that's what a Tyranid say. And I completely forgot what I was going to say. I was going to make some comment about the strategy. That's fine, we don't need to do that. What's the point of strategy? There we go, Tyranid noises, I like it. So we've got some Raveners coming in over this way, going to be looking at that critical location. Some Tactical Marines from the Good King and a Brother Captain from Tiger Shark will be coming over. Pardon me, got a bit of a king cough today. It's that time of year when tonsillitis sets in, as is its want and need. Skulls also get involved. The Raveners. I'll be honest, I completely forgot that they were here. I was too busy doing the macro. But some Spine Gaunts will be sauntering their way over, as these Raveners have been backflipped back out of nowhere. I've seen the wonderful banner of the Lamenters been popped on top of that critical location in the middle. Oh, that's what I was going to say. Yeah, so everyone likes the Lamenters. I think even though there might not be like a major chapter in the Warhammer lore, I figure there's like just like a universal love for them. They're like the Keanu Reeves of the Space Marine chapters. They've done nothing wrong, yet they've suffered so much. And we just want the best for them, really. I mean, we don't want the best for them at the moment. Tyranids, we want to eat their faces off. So help us gods, we will. The Spine Gods aren't exactly doing it for us. They're not getting that much damage done in. And I mean, I don't even know what that ability is supposed to be doing. It just raises his power sword in the air. Everyone dies. We do have some Imperial Guards, or should I say some cultist conscripts coming in over this side. Going to see if they can keep away these servitors from building up their prize. But we do have some weapon servitors avenging their brothers. Once they start firing. And very quickly these guys go down. What is that? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 dead bodies in the space of like 3 seconds. Well, to apologise, well, I've lowered the graphics down a little bit more than usual because for some reason this file just doesn't want to play with medium graphics. So I had to put it down all on low. I managed to sneak up maybe some model detail onto medium, but not much. I don't want to press the machine too hard. Just strange because I played this game on a medium, so why can't I watch it in a medium? I don't know. Either way, the cultists aren't standing up very well. Their bright pink regalia betraying their positioning. The Space Marines love these models in UA. Just firing straight down at them. Even on low graphics, they still look quite menacing. Pow, pow. Goes the bolt gun. Oh, we've got some... I do quite like... You can see like a little sliver of red firing from there. It's like... Phew, get him. Get him, boys. They can't shoot us when we're inside the pillbox. But while that's going on, we do have a flanking force of Hormagaunts coming in. You are Hormagaunts. Yes, you are Hormagaunts. Let's see if they can rip these Space Marines in two. But a weapon Servitor squad providing some firing cover for them as they retreat. Over on this side, some more Spangaunts from Lord Inquisitor here. Only one lonely tactical marine over here, so someone must have killed one. Which must be very unfortunate if you're the one and only Space Marine in the whole world probably ever been killed by a Spangaunt. It's gonna happen eventually, there's too many of them, you see. You can kill 100 of them, but they'll just get more of them. That's the whole vibe of the Tyranids. These Hormagaunts, they're looking for some Servitor meat. Not as much meat as they would like. You know, the Space Marines have got a bit more chunk to them, but they'll take whatever biomass they can get. Guardsmen over here, they're not wanting to get involved. They're just chilling out. And these guys, what are you doing? Oh, you're trying to eat. Right. So Hormagaunts got a mechanic, much like the Kroot in Soulstorm, or just in Kroot in all forms of this game, really. They eat meat, they gain more health. That's the way it works. All seeing some spore mines being thrown down by someone, not sure who. Now, for those of you who aren't aware of how the Tyranids work in the Ultimate Apocalypse, rather than like in Unification where they've got like a little sidebar here with all their abilities and it costs them some of their special econ, it's just green money. They've got like a little tab on this side. They click that, there's maybe like five abilities down there, and that's how they can summon things like spore mines in that manner, rather than storing them up in their spore chimneys and throwing them down that way. How that affects balancing, I'm not entirely sure, but the Lamenters hold firm in the centre. Brotherhood captain, a nice yellow man, proud banana standing firm against the tides, the terrors of the warp. Got a Screamer Killer on here. Double bioplasma turret, so being a little bit defensive here. We're thinking, right, well, let's not make ourselves too exposed. Let's chill out a little bit, build up our forces instead, and then go in. We're going a bit piecemeal here. So maybe we can, you know, get some more. Whether that works or not, we shall see. Got a Victoria Broodlord on the front lines here. One powerful blast from that bioplasma turret. Well, they're looking a lot more like... Oh, yeah, because they're throwing bioplasma rather than... Yeah, that makes sense. I just thought it looked a bit like plasma guns, but that makes sense. Victoria Broodlord bringing in some green stuff. More spores being chucked down. Broodlord is lucky to rip heads from shoulders, but he's not doing a great job. No one wants to be in combat with him, he'll die straight away. Now the Hive Tyrant with some Tyrant Guard coming in. In fact, actually, the Hive Tyrant has joined the Tyrant Guard here. Got some Hormagaunts for me coming in. Little stabby bits. And look at the speed of that Screamer Killer. He's looking to get some munches in there. Also screaming aloud. Terrifying T-Rex noise. And that's, I mean, look at that. That's a good amount. That's 48. 64, hold it. 48. 72 Tyranids on the go right there. A mighty amount. Whether they'll do anything there, not entirely sure. The guard are chasing around these Lamenters. Very unfortunate guys over here. Been cut down to a man. A lot of snipers there. And they are infiltrated, and none of us can really see them at the moment. So if every volley, that's at least four of these guys dead, I imagine. Even five. I mean, look how many there are in this. Oh, because you're a sergeant, you don't have a sniper. Because sergeants can't be snipers. Rule number one of being a sergeant, you lose your sniper rifle license. And where are you going? I remember Lord Inquisitor. He's decided, you know what? I don't care if my Tyranid or my Hive Tyrant doesn't have any wings. He could fly anyway. He's evolved the power of self-belief. And that's realistically the most powerful evolution one can have in the Dawn of War Warhammer 40k universe. But all the Tyranids are dead, and now the Lamenters have got time to push into other parts of the map. They've got firm control over the center here. Now also bringing out the Hellfire Dreadnoughts. Over here, the Gene Sealer Cult, they're doing something. I think they're taking up, and that's their plan. Special weapons team over here, as well as a general. The Space Marines with their melter guns looking to take down another Pyre plasma turret. Halifax Carnifex firing away with his sponges on a stick. But look at them. Shoulder guards are blazing with light. God, you're just gonna love it, don't you? A firing line of stalwart Space Marines. The good kind this time. Have the Lamenters ever done anything that's a bit of a... could be considered a immoral act from our standards in the in the Warhammer lore? That's my question today. One of many questions. But I don't think they have. But some warriors coming forth. And while the warriors are coming forth, we're always going to see a significant amount of Hormagods could begin to say hello. Mighty explosions from the bioplasma turrets. All spotted these scouts as well. Once we stand close enough to them. The Hormagods are interested in one thing and one thing only. And that's ripping apart the tactical marines. Trying to open them up like a can opener. And a good flanking on them. Means that they will have to push back a little bit. A good amount of pushing done with the infantry, but not sure if their lack of manoeuvrability is doing them in at the moment. Maybe a rhino or two would help them, prevent them from being flanked in such a manner. We are seeing some Tech Priest engine seers from a flipping nerve coming down here for reasons. Also got a Thunderfire cannon along with the weapon servitors. Oh, turn over here. Four guns akimbo. Doing what he can. He's surrounded at the moment. Absorbing a lot of damage. One Space Marine Sergeant surrounded on all sides. Somebody said it looks like he kind of gave up then. There we go. Got a mighty crack of your sword. And that's what it's going to do. Taking a lot of damage, but also sustaining himself quite nicely. More Timid Spawn Mines coming in. As the Hormagods keep on keeping on. They're on auto reinforce, as far as I'm aware. Only 20 blue as well, so relatively cheap to keep going. A never ending tide. Double warriors over here, making sure that these tacticals stay lower in the health department. Hellfire Dreadnought now in range with its auto cannon. The Hormagods might be struggling with. There's no choice but to go forward. He says as the moment they go backwards, well done, Miss Landshark. Save the Lamenters by your curse of casters. That's fine. So even after all that, the Lamenters are still holding on pretty strong here. The Special Weapons team, and they've gone for what weapons have you gone for? You've gone for sniper rifles. Interesting. So what, you're just going to try and snipe away these weapon servitors? A chaplain for the good king. Very interesting. Good frontline hero. For that all-important regen ability. Got anything good going on in my base at the moment? We've got the Phallical Magma vent. Going to go in for that tier 2 or tier 3, depending on how one looks at things. You're all taking up pretty nicely. The current economies are 265 and 191 to the good king. We've got 245 or 244 and 223. We've got 357 and 255, 239 and 138, and 118 and 138. So, even though we outnumber them, the northern team does seem to have better individual economy. We'll have better economy overall because we've got one extra full player there, but we're just going to make sure that we're using it properly. These scouts and snipers are not playing fair. The general over here, struggling a lot. But quite a cool plasma pistol there, until he died. Over on this side, I've got a significant amount of Hormagods from me. Thinking, okay, well, if you want to start pushing down the centre, you might have to deal with us on the flanks. And so he might. as the servitors, sorry, not servitors, the tech priest agency has get blasted left and right. Try to build up some defensive walls. They'll come crashing down. But the Hormagons are going to come forward and see what kind of targets they can go for. All of this stuff is probably not ideal for small and tiny Hormagons. I don't have much slashing power, but one thing that all units can universally dunk on is the plasma generator. So they decided to come over and see what they could do. They only need a couple of plasma generators exploding with that AoE damage to basically cause a chain reaction. Whether they'll be able to get it there, it's another thing entirely, as these blooming heavy bottle turrets have been teleported in from all sides. Talking about these armor gods. Double tactical marines returning back home. More or less exterminating the Hormagons over there. Back over onto this side, we are seeing the scouts trying to take out the defensive walls. It's at least buying a flipping gnome a little bit of time. Now transition away from Hormagons to warriors. Let's see what they could do with their death spitters and their venom cannons. Another scary screamer killer with his super scary roar. And how would you like a taste of your own medicine, Mr. Imperials, when we throw our own missile launchers at you, apparently? Breaking morale. Ooh, more or less getting straight back due to sergeant nonsense. But no, we are not doing well at all here. Over onto this side, we do have a flipping gnome bringing out some caskins. Very Gene Stealer cult-esque-ish. Well, rather than attacking them head-on, they've got an insurgency happening on the back lines. So Tiger Shark has brought his chaplain over. See if he can sort them out. But there we go, that's the chain reaction that you want. All those plasma gens gone. And now for Tiger Shark, we still got some plasma gen income. Not nearly as much as they could have had. Got a Gladiator Command Squad, and these guys are absolutely lethal in close combat. Got a nice little face mask as well, if I can get a good look at them. All still, boys. There we go. Very Ultramarine-esque, I don't have to say it. They look like something from the Ultramarines. The Caskers, they've seen, right, okay, we've killed all the plasma generators, let's see if we can kill any more. That's what they're running to. While that is going on, and no Lamentus to be seen. Oh, no, never mind. There are lots of Lamentus to be seen. We are now laying siege upon them at the Lieutenant's command tank. It's slow but surely pulverizing them. As the Caskins keep on going for their midnight walkabout. Servitors, on the other hand, though, they don't appreciate it. They're not massive fans of the Caskins coming through the back door. Who does, really? I'm not going to give up. They're going to keep on going. They're going to keep on going. Down on this side, more artillery being fired in from the Biovores, no less. No special mines on them as of yet, but there's a possibility for them later on. Demon Russ is focusing on the Lieutenant's command tank. Oh, listening post, sorry. Did I say that right? Not Lehman Russell, Lieutenant's command tank going up against a listing post. My words, once again, failing us. But look at this, I have some of actual wings this time. So if he starts flying, make canonical sense. That's the Caskins, by the by, they're all dead. Take it to the wall and shot. Hellfire Dreadnought unable to fight back. He's got no arms. And now he's surrounded. I suppose one good advantage of being surrounded is that no matter which way you fire, you're probably bound to hit an enemy. There's not all bad news in Dreadnought Town. Not all bad news at all. There's a bit of a mosh pit going on. On the northern side, scouts are being murdered by Gene Stealers. On the southern side, we've got a Lieutenant's Command Squad bashing and boofing anyone that he can. And from the western side, you have got some crazy Tyranids finishing off that circuit. Lamenters, they're now transitioning towards Vanguard veterans. It's probably where they want to be. No regular Devastators or Space Marines for these guys. They need the elite of the elite. They need the cream of the crop if they want to see some victory here today. And speaking of cream of the crop, I don't know where that saying comes from. I think it comes from some sort of like farming thing. But when I was a kid, I always thought that cream of the crop was just like some sort of food. Which it's not, because cream does not come from wheat or crops or anything like that. So I thought that was lied to as a child growing up. But Gladiators over here, they're going up against some Gene Stealers. Lots of explosions going on down there. Not doing them any favours. Lots of firepower from the Gene Stealer cultists. There's some psychics as well, standing on the edge. The Lieutenant's Command tank firing into the centre of this scrum going on over on this side. From the fire cannon, being engaged with a lot of melee stuff, which is not where it wants to be. What are you even firing at? One lonely, melty Minotauran priest. Poor lad, he's up for quite some time before dying in the end. His psychers getting shot down straight away by bolt of fire. One mighty force commander, the Borealis, charging forward with his melter gun and his warhammer. Look at that double plasma cannons hitting him on the backside. And does he fall over? Absolutely not. No, not back on that kid. He's got a venerable dreadnought and a Terminator squad over onto this side. We do have blooming colonel over here, as well as a field command lieutenant. Just regular boys clad in pink. Just look at the size difference on these guys. Must be a very brave man to go up against a Terminator on you. But then again, if you believe that the gods themselves are ready to come over and consume the planet, you might as well be brave yourself. Got some snipers over here firing down the middle as well. What's going on over on this? We've got double storm swords being popped down up on the northern side of the good king's base. Love the spread of these heavy bolt turrets. Really anticipating any sort of bad stuff incoming. We'll see these plasma generators being shot up while the assault terminators see if they can bonk the sides of the storm sword with their hammers. Takes them no time at all to annihilate it. A double of them going off most at the same time. Gotta be really careful of those Terminators. Quite lethal. Got some more Hormigons coming in because, well, I just like the tiny Tyranids. You know, everyone's like, ooh, look at all these big blooming carnifexes and stuff. And I'm like, nah, mate. The little ones is where it's at. This is a lot more fun to watch. Look at them go. Just, it's like, yeah, I'll get you. I'm gonna get you. And they don't get them often, but when they do, it's a pleasure to see. Look at this poor soul over here. Up against four of them. Morale been broken. Trying to slap him around with his gun. And punch him in the face, but no, they're going to get him eventually. Go and get him. Someone. Oh, will he survive? The fight of one singular Space Marine. He lives to go forward once more. I wonder if in a Dawn of War game how often a singular model survives the entire game. How time be scared away by these mighty melter guns. Oh, they saw the graviton guns. So these big green doofus here. Leaf as you like. We are now starting to see a Ter Vigon, if I can pronounce that, as well as a Hive Tyrant and a Carnifex. So a mixture of big ones and small ones. Termagants are the ones that allow you to summon more Hormigons and Termagants in the middle of stuff. You might be saying, oh, Miss Landshot, why don't you get Termagants with your Hormigons? And I thought, nah, mate. Termagants are for nerds. Who needs a gun? Aliens don't need guns. They need sharp bits and gnashing teeth. Look at these Gene Stealers. Gorillas in the mist. Coming from out of nowhere. That's bloody terrifying, that. Absolutely murdering the poor Lamenters that we saw earlier on, I imagine. Whole squad here been wiped out. God, that was terrifying. More Hormigons coming round for the flanks. Oh, that's some nightmare fuel for you right there, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, blimey. Combination of Zornfrips as well. Firing in the good stuff. So potentially we might see a huge zone front ball, which we've seen many times on this channel be quite the efficient thing to do against Space Marines when playing as the Terminators. We've got a lot of plasma guns been fired in from these turrets. Server going in the middle. It's going to go turret to turret against Boreal himself. A mighty rending claw casting down while he's been surrounded by a lot of these little ones, as well as a Hive Tyrant coming in as well. But he's holding on. Good lord, a mighty last stand, all things considered. But he's going to do it now. He teleports away. Lives to fight another day. Always knew Boreal was a member of the Lamenters, deep down on the inside. Devastator's engaging in melee combat. Not the most ideal situation for them. As the Tyranids swarm across this area, land raid of Phoebus. Should I learn the other day, Phoebus is one of the small moons of Mars, I think. There's Phoebus, and then there is the other one, which might be its official name, I'm not entirely sure. Venable Dreadnought, he's brave, but not very clever, going up against all those by himself. Well, an unending tide of Tyranids now going towards Tiger Shark's base. The first listing person has been taken down. It's a little bit like League of Legends. We've got three layers of turrets before we go into the heart of it. Well, this Zone Thumps are falling back as well as the Hive Turret. Why are you falling back? Oh, because there's stuff going on. There's a lot of Terminators. As we've seen earlier on, Terminators kill things very fast and they don't die very fast. So that's a huge problem for Lord Inquisitor, in consideration to the fact that his base is here, as opposed to Space Marine's base, which is kind of like a lot bigger and wider. In a base trade, we won't win, and we have also lost all of our little ones as well. One squad of, I mean, Noga Bonehead. Oh, because the Colonel gets an Noga Bonehead as part of his retinue. Okay, fair enough. It turned out as being a nuisance. I'm going to teleport around here, get a flank on these Zone Thrups, at least splitting them in two. Got Capillary Vein gesticulating in the wind. This Tervagon tries to take care of these double Terminators on this side. Venable Dreadnought being teleported, and this is a lot of high value Space Marine stuff in such a small area. Gene Sealers need to get on with it if they can. The Terminators use their maneuverability. A Storm Sword Titanicus. Very little effect there against these Assault Terminators. And the Uberfex might not be one to live for very long in this situation. Got a lot of my dudes. We're trying to get over. What are we fighting on this side? We are fighting some very, very unfortunate. Are you Gladiators? Stand still. Gladiator Command Squad. They're Triple Carnifex. And the Tervagon. Yeah, they're in a bad situation. So they're going to go up against these guys while the Hormagons come over. See if they can at the very least keep these Terminators occupied. I do like the way that they bounce as well. It's a little hop. Makes me think of like a really aggressive Bambi. I've Spire. Been punched to death. Well, the Terminators also got these lads in the corner setting fire to everything. It's all going so well. We was assaulting like never before. Lord Inquisitor taking the brunt of this counter-assault from the Lamenters here. And what are you doing, Gene Sealer Cults? You are building more Lehman Russes. You have got one Storm Sword Titanicus over here. Found out these lads. And you've also got a thermonuclear generator being built up as well. Alright, fair enough, you're doing stuff. Thankfully, gradually, we are scaring these guys away. Also, Ironclad Dreadnought. Now struggling. Giving these Hormagons a squeeze before throwing one away. Good for those uppercuts as well. Everyone being chased away. We're asking to give each other requisition here. A flipping gnome requires money for potential shenanigans. Ah, he's got a nuclear weapons center over here. So looking for some explosive things. Server god of mine, or as well as the Carnifexes, thinking about doing stuff. You see these missiles coming in, think, well, why not? You've garnered our attention. Let's go forth and see if we can sort you out as the Tyranid Swarms continue chasing these Terminators. See as well, the Good King's Terminators have all been upgraded with the... Come back here. With the missiles on their back. Whereas the Assault Terminators don't have that, but any regular Terminators will automatically have that from here on out, as that is an upgrade, or global upgrade, for the Space Marines here. We've got some more Carnifexes to have seen. The scouts. Servagon's just trying to push in and see what's going on. So double stuff going on. So pushing in from two edges here. That's what we want to see. Oh, this funneling down one side or one canal. Oh no, there, look at that. The Jizil occult having access to the nuclear codes. Exploding a good chunk of the base, but one thing that you'll notice is that when that happens, they've also exploded all of the Tyranids as well. Dear, oh dear. Sad as well, because I've had to lower the graphics, you won't see that expanding ring of fire, which is really sad. They did look really cool, but nope, the game was like, nope. Your graphics need to be on low, you bastard. So fine, fair enough. We're here anyway. But these guys haven't died from the nuclear fire. They're continuing. They're being held back by one score of Terminators. I do like Ultimate Apocalypse in the way that it definitely makes Terminators feel like Terminators. You can't just get one dude holding the line for quite some time, even against Carnifex. Got some more Hormigons. If they bro, don't fix it. Keep them coming. But now there's this whole avenue of fire that they've got to go through. These scouts doing a wonderful job at spotting as well. A Shadow Sword. I'm not sure what he's doing. I think we've even seen him fire yet. Oh, there we go. One shot in there with his spinning tip. And a Trigon. Multiple spiky bits on that lad. And Carnifex, but longer and sliverier. Sliverier is even an adjective. He's going to sprint in there. Get some stereo bits on. Gladiator still knocking around as the big tank goes down. And yeah, it seems like it's just Terminators for both Lamenta players here. These guys not really cutting through the command squad as quickly as we'd hope. Another Doom effects. The biggest of the bunch. He's going to stab these guys right up the jacksie. As my frame rate begins to suffer. Got Raveners in there as well. These guys just been surrounded. We're also doing surrounding as well. But not a favourable situation for them, so they're going to run away. After all, they don't need to win these individual engagements. They've already done a lot of damage to Lord Inquisitor, who's now rebuilt his Hive Spire down here. They just need to survive the incoming nukes, which are always incoming. I mean, they've managed to kill the nuclear weapons center. They've got a Titan Assembly bunker now has a flipping gnome. What's going on down here? Oh, there's a Force Commander. Look at him go. He's resisting all incoming damage. He has seen this Titan Assembly bunker. He's like, no, you shall not have one. That is heresy. You're not allowed a Gene Stealer cult Titan. Can you imagine how terrifying that would be? You got some biomass in there. I wonder if the Hive Tyrant or the Hive Mind absorbed a human. And the humans are like, yep, I will tell you all the information about making a Titan. Well, I suppose they've already got their own Bio-Titan, haven't they? So they don't really need to copy the Imperium's plan. It would look a bit goofy if they were made of flesh. The Flesh Titan. Yeah, cone effects is there. To be fair, the stabby bits on them, while doing quite a lot of damage, aren't exactly doing it for me here. They're not cutting through these guys like I was hoping they would. They seem to be more like damage sponges rather than damage not sponges. The opposite of a sponge is the opposite of a sponge. A hose. A jet stream. A jet stream of DPS. There we go. Poor Homogos here. They've got nowhere to go. They're trying against combat, but two of the missiles coming in. Very unfair, if you ask me. The far left side of the map, we have got the Terminators once again coming in. Looking for more. The Colonel and his Bonehead. As well as a fire support lieutenant. That must be some sort of fun D&D group going on there. They've rolled their initiative. They've got advantage. But against Terminators, they're going to be struggling even with a good character sheet. These Terminators are just ignoring them, looking for that economic damage. As I turn away from supporting all this going on and bringing our lads over onto this side. See what they can kill. Kind of effects here. Up against all these Terminators by himself. Ah, be gentle. That's just mean, if anything. They've even got an apothecary in there, so they become even more tankier than they need to be. Wonderful. I mean, these Whirlwind Mark IIs really getting in that value. Just constantly being fired in. Much more satisfying than the Mark I, who only fires one missile at a time. These guys just have like a smattering of gunpowder. The Terminators aren't going to go down. So what do we need to do to beat the Terminators? We need something elite heavy infantry, anti, if that, just rearrange those words in that sentence, it makes sense. So Zonthrops. Zonthrops are what we need. Zonthrops are what we want. A mass of Zonthrops to shoot down these. And then try and keep away from these Whirlwind Mark IIs, as the Zonthrops are quite fragile. That would be the idea. But will we realise this in time? That's the question. As Lord Inquisitor is losing quite a lot of his base. I'm going to build up some bio-acid hive nerds in the hopes that maybe some big turrets might help us crack open these Terminators. They should, in theory, do a good job, as they are quite good against most things. The artillery bombardment there. A lot of damage to these turrets. In fact, already killing two. Not as much damage against the field command, but the field command is a heavily fortified structure, as opposed to the turret emplacement, which is just a structure. I'm also going to see a Titanicus firing in down here. Far left corner, what's going on down there? Oh, right, okay, you're building an extra base down there. That makes sense. Just in case we see any nuclear strikes coming in from the space beam perspective. So are we seeing any nuclear sensors? We've got one from Tag Shark. And it looks like he's already researched one thing. None from the Good King there. Gotta keep our eyes open for any missile or nuclear stuff from those guys. Terminators have killed the big tank again. Probably no need to go for those big tanks anymore, as those guys have not really left much of a mark in this game so far. Oh, I said, no, you're doing much. You're not doing an incredible amount of damage, and now you'll be doing very little damage. Very little damage indeed. Here comes another force commander. We can actually see this one this time. He's surrounded. Look at him just punching the general. Square around the jowls. What a fire finger said to the face. Slap. That's how Rick James would do it if he was a Terminator. And this is an epic show-off, isn't it? Or standoff. Oh, we've also got Blimmin' What's Your Name? Chapter Master in there as well. Back to back. Oh, it's like a Black Library novel. Two main characters going up against everyone. And he's doing a fair bit of damage as well. He's not messing around at all. They've got their overall shields. Forskvon is going to have to run away there. Able to take him on. The mighty of the Adeptus Astartes. So portent's looking quite favourable for the Lamentus here. But we do have the Titan Assembly Bunker now bringing out a Reaver Titan. Don't know if there's any more chemicals. Oh no, right, so he's going to go for a Basilisk Magnus is our flipping gnome. Which will be able to provide some serious artillery support across the map. We have a Chaplain in Terminator armor now. As the last of those counter effects go down. What am I doing over here? I've got Capillary Tower. I've also got a Hierophant Bio Titan. So, I mean, we've got some big stuff on the incoming as well. It's not just the Space Marines. I've got some good stuff. We've also got a mean few customers as well. Siege over here still continuing as Tiger Shark is building up his forces. Stangard veterans in with Terminators. Your Stangard veterans, what are you equipped with? You're equipped with Graviton Cannons, which are like those guns we saw earlier, but just bigger and badder. Much more imposing. Scary stuff, if you ask me. Oh, you've also got... Right, so you've got the Construct Super Weapon on the go. Hierophant, looking to see what he could do. Also got double heavily fortified defense walls, but the Terminators have seen this Basilisk Magnus. Hasn't been finished constructed yet. If left to their own devices, they will kill it quite quickly, so we need to get on the defense about it. Got triple Vindicare Assassins down here, trying to pick off these Assault Terminators. But even their rifles, can they penetrate the armor of these Terminators? Fix Ceramites against Vindicare bullets. Who will win? Some zone throps. There we go, Lord Inquisitor, he's got the idea. Zone throps finally firing into the mass of Assault Terminators, although we do need more. Definitely need more. The Assault Basilisk. Or the Basilisk Magnus, sorry. Not yet been finished. You can tell by the slanted nature of the gun. Oh, there we go, it's finished now. I'm just going to try and fire down here. But it's too close, gosh darn it. Gonna have to fire somewhere else. It's got a chance for one shot. One shot alone. Only get one off. Hierophant's trying to get down here. And I realised, oh no, there's a wall. There's also a really annoying Chapter Master. One Chapter Master against a Titan. And he's not gonna win it. But he's sacrificing himself to save his Terminator brothers. All Smorgasbord Attuned Warriors and support. The assault as well. One big whip crack from that Hierophant Titan. We're all seeing me. I'm using my nuclear ability down here because I just want to kill the Terminators, but then they teleported away. I was hoping that they wouldn't realize what was going on. There's big explosions happening all over the place. So they might get got. There we go. Small explosion there. Woo, well done us. Yeah, the problem with the Genezilla nuke is that, one, it's not very localized. It takes a while for the big thing to happen. We'll all see the big thing happen here. We got a massive explosions. And then, whoa, as the Capillary Towers come forth. And finally, breathe a sigh of relief, boys and girls. The Terminators have been killed by a tactical nuke of Capillary Towers. But the amount of damage that those guys did over the space of what how long did that assault last for? About maybe like 10 minutes? They killed all of this and all of this. My Titan could not get in there, but hoo-wee, we killed him in the end. Even if it took an entire nuke to kill out three squads. Well, what's going on? We've got a whole Titan here. I was killed by the super weapon of Tiger Shark. And now it's going to just roam around on this side. So we need to buy a new Titan. Another Uber effects down here from Lord Inquisitor. I've got a Hierophant coming on down this way. Now there's time for revenge. 200 warriors on either side. A mighty crack of that tail whip there. More timid warriors ready to get involved in the moment. I remember to air move them. And what can the Space Marines do now without their precious Terminators? Well, of course, they could just build more. Because, I mean, we're now in that stupid stage of Ultimate Apocalypse where everyone's got ridiculous amounts of money. So losing your squads isn't actually the end of game situation it could be. The Good King has now also got his own nuclear weapons. And as this is going on, we are seeing... I mean, who does this belong to? Who's controlling this satellite thingy? Yep, Tiger Shark, he's got another one. He's now built up multiple nuclear sites. And he's killed my HQ. So there's all my tech gone. Also, my capillary vein is dead as well. So no more nukes for me. Yeah, how many nuclear things have you got, Tiger? Ah, you've got two. So you're able to host two nuclear bombs at a time. Well, that's good. Oh, pardon me. Oh, bless me even. Terminator's just bonked the Hierophant Titan down. That's it, with your Space Marines. Don't even bother going for your Titans. Just build up your blooming Assault Terminators. That's all you need. Assault Terminators with Thunder Hammers. That's the job. Tinder Warriors, no match against these stubby boys. Most of the Predator Annihilator with a conversion beam. Which, I don't know how familiar you are with UK politics, but conversion beams were banned in the UK sometime during the last Conservative government. Or during this current one, sorry. There's been so many of them, it's hard to remember. Oh, that was an obscure reference. We'll see if anyone gets that one. Bassus Magnus being rebuilt down here. I've been rebuilt with the handy work of these Ripper Swarms. Just vomiting over it. Good old vomit structures. Down over here, we're going to rebuild my Hive Spire. See if we can regain our former glory. So these capillary towers are not the same as those giant ones that let me nuke things. They just sit there. All wiggling in the wind gently. No major wiggle, just a gentle listle. A listily wave to the left and right. Predator Annihilator about to get blown up. Potentially. Yeah, not thinking before I was driving there. And we do have some more Storm Swords being thrown in. Looking to take on those nuclear weapon sensors. Absolutely crucial that they kill them. Must get them down before they could fire any more nuclear weapons at us. Although I don't know if they've got any spare at the moment. Keep an eye on our base just in case they get any fresh ideas. Yep, this guy is saved. And this guy is potentially saved. What are you doing, Valkyrie? Oh, he's coming over for a quick alert. Storm Sword on the cusp of saving us from this nuclear weapon sensor. Can they get it? Yes, does look like it. Go for one more shot from the mighty cannon. Nice. That's one less nuclear weapon we've got to worry about. But in saying that, Good King still got his. And it's not looking pretty. Got another nuclear weapon sensor for a flipping gnome down here. Basilisk Magnus. God, that's such a hard thing to say. It's on the rounds have been completed. And the Hormagods, baby. Might be tier 5 at the moment, but I've lost my tech. So back to tier 1 and tier 2 strategies. Let's see what these guys can do. So right over here. Oh, shit. Oh, God, blimey. I have no idea what happened there. Well, actually, I do know what happened there. But I pressed the delete button accidentally instead of the hashtag button. But we're back. Can't remember exactly where we left off. But the Hormagods were there. And now they're not because of Predator Annihilators with conversion beams. One singular lad from the Gladiator Command Squad remaining. Look at him go with his blooming little nipples on his shoulder pads. Those got nukes happening. Which is just lots of little beams and one mega beam in the middle. It's going to go around and anything. Look at this, just another kill. It's like a mini exterminatus. As the predators go towards my base. Insane amounts of damage being done. And these are just going to keep on going on forever and ever, our men. Till eventually, everything is dead. It's quite literally a mini exterminatus. Very pretty, all things considered. Look at the smoothness of its moving through the base. I mean, it does fade out a little bit, but we'll come back, I imagine. Quite handsomely taking out the Jeezy LeCult base. And that's one way to get rid of a Tyranid infestation. Scorched Earth tactics. Burn everything. Soul Terminator is going to finish off these Hive Spires. Tunnel Warrens, as well as the Reclamation Pools, all been uprooted. Is there a post on the side of this nuclear thing? Oh, there is. The new John Wick film, I imagine. Dagshack says, we stand, the Lamenters are not going anywhere today. Storm Sword looking to see if we can do some stuff. Big old cannon, some flamers on the sides. That's a lot of Terminators. We've seen bigger things fall to smaller amounts of Terminators. Bastus Magnus is still online. The turn is cannon around. See if we can shoot at those guys over there. Or maybe not. What are you going to go for? Make your choice. Look at just the sheer amount of AoE it does. Does it kill them all? No, but it'll only take a couple of shots. I mean, yeah, three shots and all at half health. So if we got this up a lot earlier, if we was able to defend it, that might have changed the course of action. All these cheeky tank traps been placed by Gnome. But the Terminators teleport in. And now that... Oh no, he can shoot down there. They're now going to drop down some more. So it's not over yet. They've also got another Hierophant Bio Titan. But we're going to be blocked off by... It's not the Titan's day, is it? Too many narrow things it can't get around. See, this guy's like, bye, sucker. See you later, nerd. Run straight past these. Going to throw some plasma at them. Besides, turn around and take the long way home. Also got a severe amount of Marspan convoys. Not sure what they're doing there other than just to be a bullet sponge. But the Basilisk. It's taking all the Terminators down here, but there's even more coming down on this side. But a swarm of Hormagons earlier on, now it's just a swarm of Terminators. The Carnivore, well, the Uberfect, sorry. Over here, armed with a Venom Cannon and a Bioplasm mouthpiece. Walking past the Storm Sword. We'll see the Whirlwind Mark IIs. As the Bio Titan tries to speed his way down here. Getting caught on the side of a Storm Sword there. Need to make room for each other. Oh, we're just holding on to the last dregs of tech that we have. The Magnus on red health now. As the Storm Sword tries to burn away. These filthy humans. Why can't they just stand still and be food for 5 minutes? They're not going to. And we do have the Gladiator Command Squad still knocking about. Going toe-to-toe with this Titan, doing a damn fine job about it. The mouth's been broken. They won't win this fight. They're not nearly as durable as the Terminators. I mean, they're distracting him. Stopping him from going over this way. Those long legs of his. Well, the Magnus has gone down. Terminators now turn their attention to everything else. What else can be done? We are seeing We are seeing Lord Inquisitor building up a hive spire over here. Just need to get some Ripper Swarms down. Not sure if he's got any spare. Got a Bubbling. Bubbling Cat on the face doing a little dance with the Hiver Fan. Are we losing? Yes, but you know what? The Uberfex is still going to enjoy himself. If you can enjoy yourself when the times are hard, then you've basically won life, haven't you? It's not about having the most, it's about requiring the least. Put a PNG of an Uberfex with that inspirational quote there. Stick that on your desk in your office when those days are getting tough. Just remember the happy Uberfex. The nuclear weapons sensor being spotted by the Terminators. We can't have fun, apparently. We're not allowed to have any big toys. Not one of the Lamenters are in town. Even more dudes coming on. Stormlord now. Primarily against infantry is this lad. Big shooty bits, no large cannons. Just many and many a gun. Not sure where the Hierophant... Oh, Hierophant is coming back down here because he wants to stop all these Terminators. Would have probably benefited if we just sent him over to the northern side. Take on the Lamenters at their home, but... We want to keep our base alive as long as possible. It's only fair. They have a base, we should be allowed to have a base as well. One singular Landspeed of Tempest in the air. As the Hierophant is struggling. Gives a sheer amount. Servite in front of it. Gives him a good stabbing. Doesn't seem to have much in the way of AoE damage. It doesn't... Can't really tell, can you? Yeah, I mean, I imagine if they were, like, lightly armoured infantry, loads of people would be knocked around, but these guys are just knock-over resistant. But it does seem like they're taking a bit of damage. A lot of the models are dead on the floor at the moment. They are fading into the floor due to the low graphic settings. I've got a... No, they was thinking about building up another Bastus Magnus there. We're standing against it. But we're holding, baby. We're holding. There's time to stabilise. Yeah, okay, fair enough. These Terminators have killed all this stuff over here, but we are rebuilding over onto this side, I think. This side and this side. And if one Bio-Titan can take on all those Terminators by himself, imagine what he could do supported. We are going to get some support sometime soon. Another Bio-Acid Hide at Nerve. About double of them been stricken up. Now we just have the Chapter Master to deal with. Get him got. Get him done. He's got a shield there. He's able to resist some of the incoming damage. But Titan has been defeated. Falling over. Looking like that, he's falling over. Also killed that building. I'm not sure if that's actually how it works. In fact, I'm fairly certain that's not how it works. But it looked cool all the same. A little happy coincidence. And now, here come another Exterminatus-esque kind of thing going on. Just an orbital bombardment from the Deep Strike Beacon, wherever they've got one over there. But still, enough to keep these other people away. And, there we go. Another load of explodey bits going on this side. And then from this side, we are seeing... Oh, we've got some more exploding bits over there. Hey, it's just a grand old time. We've got a million heavy bolts that's been summoned in by the good king. And a nuclear bomb up on this side. Just because screw you. That's why. We were dead, and now we're super dead. It's like as if they've got, like, five nukes saved up. I thought, okay, well, we'll let them think they could defend themselves. And then we'll just get them all together. So, boys and girls, I'm going to... No, let's watch the fireworks. Because realistically, the rest of this game is... us just trying to cockroach and stay alive for as long as possible by rebuilding our HQs. Super weapon being summoned down over there. There's not much else to do other than watch as all our hopes and dreams get dashed by the superior naval might of the Space Marines. Field Commander over there being taken down, soon to be taken down over here as well. It was a good game. Like I said, sometime in the middle of this match, our unit composition should have been a lot more Zernfrup orientated. What's going on? What are you blowing up over there? Oh, you're just chilling out. Sounds like particle cannon. That's fair enough. But yeah, oh dear. But yeah, our unit composition wasn't exactly ideal. Wasn't exactly what we wanted. Lament is the victory. There we go. Let's also have a look at the stats while we're here. But yeah, I think less Hormigaunts would have served well from my perspective, but they just look so cool, don't they? But yeah, those are all the things. Many people died. Units killed 1,128. Amazing stuff. Grand total of, actually, that's 2,000 kills from the Lamenta side. Ooh, I might put that in the thumbnail. Ho-ho! That'll get some clicks, won't it? Nice one. I mean, I'm only losing 150 models to Tiger Sharks, so very impressive. All the same. Resources, it's just UA stuff, isn't it? And technology, it's also UA stuff. So yeah, thank you so much, guys, for playing this game with us the other night. And yeah, if you want to support the channel, have a look at the old Patreon. £1 a month gets you one extra game a week. And there is also a Discord, where Discord things happen. My name's been Mr. Landshark. Pleasure as always, never chop. And I will see you in a bit. Peace.